Good morning. It's Wednesday, February 12th, 2020. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled, When the Foundation Crumbles. And our scripture is Proverbs chapter 6. What are worthless and wicked people like? They are constant liars, signaling their deceit with a wink of the eye, a nudge of the foot, or a wiggle of the fingers. Their perverted hearts plot evil, and they constantly stir up trouble. But they will be destroyed suddenly, broken in an instant beyond all hope of healing. There are six things the Lord hates, no, seven things he detests: haughty eyes, a lying tongue, hands that kill the innocent, a heart that plots evil, feet that race to do wrong, a false witness who pours out lies, a person who sows discord in a family. A family, any kind of family, people gathered for any purpose of home, business, government, or some kind of endeavor, have both the possibility of experiencing success or crumbling defeat. It all depends on trust and truth. Jesus made sure we understood how you cannot overestimate the value of truth. He said it so plainly in teaching his disciples, identifying everything he did, said, and meant as steeped in and sourced by truth. He claimed to be the very embodiment of truth when he told his questioning disciple Thomas, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father except through me." Truth is so intricately woven into the fabric of God's creation that humans can never achieve God's purposes for our lives if there's a crack in the truth foundation. And therein is the answer to why things fall apart. God's purposes are clear, right, and unfailing, and they are inexorably tied to truth. The example of Adam and Eve's fall hinges on the truth. In Eden, we observe the chief enemy, Satan, tempting Eve, planting a seed of doubt over what God had commanded. 18 seed words of doubt, which began generations of misery in Genesis 3. Did God really say you must not eat the fruit from any of the trees in the garden? It was a question, but not an innocent one. Satan was setting Eve up. This was a plot, an evil ploy to get Eve to intentionally transgress against God's instructions. The enemy's evil lying tongue deceived the innocent woman, sowing a seed of doubt against God's sovereignty. When Adam and Eve allowed that seed to take root, truth was violated, and the fruit was full-blown discord between God and all humanity. For you today, no one can undo history. We can't go back and undo Adam and Eve's fall. Neither can we return to the scene of the crime of our own first sins. What is done is forever done. But we can affect the present and the future. We can make a commitment to truth. We can affirm God's sovereignty over us, trusting that Christ's forgiveness extended from the cross is true. The original foundation may have crumbled, but a new building is possible. He said it was so. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone. A new life has begun. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.